Raymond runs a repair shop for flat fender era Jeep vehicles. He apparently does a lot of axle work, and that's what prompted his question. I think a pinion depth gauge fixture would help my situation. I remember Summit Racing and others sell something, but they all seem to be brand specific, Ford, Chevy, etc. Have you come across any that would work with the 40s, 50s, and 60s Jeep axles? As axle builders, Raymond and I, and many others, know that setting the pinion depth is the most important and preliminary step in setting up a ring and pinion gear set. Raymond works on Jeep vehicles that have Spicer and Dana integral axles. And on these axles, fortunately, the pinion gear heads from the factory and even aftermarket are indexed or marked with a specific depth indication. From that vintage, that indicator is in thousandths of an inch, and the charts in a factory workshop manual give you a reference for how to shim the depth of the pinion, assuming that the ring and pinion gear are in their proper position to start with, and this is usually the case if the axle's never been rebuilt or there's never been a ring and pinion gear change. You can rely on the shimming indicator marks at the head of the pinion gear. Within the magazine, you'll find my axle builds on a Dana 30 and a Dana 35 axle that have these pinion gear head marks, and you can see how I set up a pinion depth. Whenever there's a question, however, about whether the original marks are accurate or whether someone has been inside this axle and possibly misset the ring and pinion gear, you need to start with the basic assumption that the pinion needs to be set from scratch, and that requires special tools. This is my Miller SPX specialty toolkit for finding the pinion depth on a blank axle housing. This set is specifically for Dana axles, Spicer Dana. And the basic idea is that you will use these arbors underneath the bearing caps, match pair of arbors like this, underneath the bearing caps to establish a center line of where the axle shafts run through the center of the differential. Once you establish that actual center line, there is a set of tools used with a dial indicator to specifically find where the pinion gear head should butt. Once you establish that pinion gear head height and set the pinion bearing preload, you're well on the way to setting up the ring and pinion gear. If a shop like Raymond's does enough volume of axle building with blank housings or housings where there's some suspicion around whether the ring and pinion gears were set up properly, this tool is very valuable. It's available through Miller SPX. There is a website for OTC SPX tools for Chrysler applications, which would be Jeep. This particular set carries all the way from a Spicer 25 through a Dana 70 axle. You can get specific breakdowns from there, but these full sets usually make the best sense if you're working on a wide range of vehicles. If you don't do a large volume of axle building, maybe this is a one-shot or even an emergency situation, you can rely on the marks on the pinion gear head and the existing shim pack to get a base setting of the ring and pinion gear. Once you followed the instructions and have set up the ring and pinion, preloaded the pinion shaft bearings, preloaded the carrier bearings, you can do a tooth contact pattern of the ring and pinion gear as I describe in all of my axle builds within the magazine, and do your final ring and pinion gear mesh tests based on painting the gears and running a tooth contact pattern. See my tips on the use of dummy bearings to do preliminary setup of the ring and pinion gear. That and painting the teeth for a tooth contact pattern will suffice if you simply take your time and follow through with the steps necessary.